children. Ah, where is Dean? I'm supposed to be meeting him here. We're talking about miracles today. We're supposed to be meeting here, but I don't know where he is. I'm gonna have to go find him and then I'll come back to you, okay? See you in a minute. Dean! Dean! Dean? Dean here? Dean? Dean?
Got it!
What are you doing?
I found it, Bec.
What is it? What do you mean you found it?
Bec,
what are you wearing today, Dean?
Bec, we're talking about miracles.
Yeah?
I've got a miracle for you and for you, Bec!
Okay, I'm not sure you understand what we're talking about today.
Piece of string.
Okay, yeah, piece of string.
Piece of string, check. Is that piece of string?
Yeah, piece of string.
Okay.
Okay.
So I have a piece here that I'm going to thread my piece of string through this little bit here.
Okay.
So here it goes, through there.
Yep, yep, yep.
Okay, move back to forwards, piece of string. Ready? Say the magic word, poo a lot. And here we go. Look at that, String is in two.
Let me check,
shut up. Check, have a look. Feel that?
Whoa, what? You split it in half, that's really clever.
Yeah, but now look, no poo. Back.
Well done, Dean.
A miracle.
No, that's not a miracle. That's a trick.
Yeah.
That's a trick.
It's just a trick.
It's trickery, isn't it? Yeah.
Yeah.
That's what magicians do. It's trickery. That's not what we're talking about today. We're talking about miracles.
So what is a miracle then?
So a miracle is when an event happens that's completely out of the ordinary and can't be explained.
Ooh. Yeah, but those sort of things only happened in the Bible.
Wow. Can you remember some of the miracles that happened in the Bible?
Yeah, so they turn water into wine, which is totally unexplained.
Yeah.
And then there was a man, wasn't there, who was blind, and then Jesus spat on his eyes, and he could see again, totally unexplained.
Yeah. And there was the man who was lame, he couldn't walk, and then Jesus said, pick up your mat and walk, and he did.
Totally unexplained.
Yeah. But they're all miracles, and miracles, that's just the amazing thing about them.
Yeah, but they don't happen now, do they? Come on.
Dean? Okay, so maybe they don't happen in the same way as they did in Bible times because Jesus was there and you could see Jesus performing the miracles, but Jesus still performs miracles today.
No, he doesn't.
Oh, he does? Right, Dean, I've got some friends you need to go and talk to because they have experienced their own miracles.
Really?
Absolutely. You need to go off and speak to our friends. Give me the magic trick. Give me the hat. In there, not this kind of miracle. Go and speak to our friends and discover how their miracles happened recently.
Right, I'm going.
Yeah.
I'm going.
Miracles, magic tricks.
Ah, Cynthia!
Hi, Dean.
I didn't realise it was you I was going to chat to.
It's me today.
So this has got me really intrigued, right? So me and Becky have been talking about miracles and they don't happen today.
Yeah.
But you have got a miracle story.
I have got a miracle story to share.
Wow, okay, I'm really excited. Okay, so kind of for Cynthia, what is your miracle story?
Right, my miracle story is around about 5 or 6 years ago.
Right, okay.
I was in one of the Tuesday night healing services.
Right, okay.
And I was born with, on my right eye, I was born with like a slight mole in it. I would call it a mole, but it was like a brown mark from the iris, from the edge of the iris. And I even had to put it on my passport as an identification, because sometimes on passports you've got to put on there whether you've got a mole somewhere or whatever. And I actually put that on my passport, I had a mole in my right eye.
Right in your eye?
On my eyeball, yeah.
Wow. Did it stop your vision? Did it?
It never stopped my vision. It didn't bother me at all. I wasn't in any pain or anything.
Right, okay.
In fact, it was just part of me, like my arms and my legs.
Right.
So I just left it there, never worried about it. My mom never took me to the doctors about it.
Yeah.
And it was just there. And in the service, I didn't go up for prayer or anything because I didn't think I needed healing at that time. And I felt a sharp pain in my right eye.
Whoa.
It was ever so strange. It was like someone had took a pin and just did that to it.
Ooh.
I know it sounds really, really awful, but it was just a quick split second.
Yeah.
Just rubbed my eye, never thought anything more about it. Because as I said earlier, that mole never bothered me, so I never thought anything more.
Yeah.
And then about 5 or 6 days later, it's quite a while ago, so I'm going by memory, looked in my eye and it wasn't there. It had completely gone. It was just incredible, that eye, bit as clear. So that to me was like a miracle and the healing at the same time, even though I wasn't in any pain or...
Wow. So, and just to have a mole just disappear, just like that, wow, that
just
is a miracle.
Just like that, and to me that's a miracle.
Wow. Well, I am so impressed with God that he can do a miracle like that.
Yeah, I am as well.
Wow. Well, thanks, Cynthia, for coming
in. You're ever so welcome.
Brilliant. Well, I'm going to go back to Becky now and tell her what you've told me.
Yeah, and everybody else that you know.
I'm going to do it. Beck, what an interesting day.
Yeah, see, told you.
Just talking to those people who actually experienced the miracle in their own lives.
Yeah,
wow.
I knew you'd enjoy talking to them. Wow. Yeah.
And Beck, you know, when I were talking, it was like, you know, what is impossible for man is possible for God. That's a Bible verse, isn't it? In Luke 18, verse 27, Jesus replied, "What is impossible with man is possible with God." And that's exactly what happened.
Yeah, incredible. And those people, you know, they all believed in God, and then they saw those miracles. You know, they'd heard about miracles in the Bible, but they've been able to see those miracles with their own eyes.
Wow,
didn't they? Yeah. And there's a verse in the Bible that talks about that as well. In Deuteronomy 10, verse 21, it says, "He is the one you praise. He is your God who performed for you those great and awesome wonders that you saw with your own eyes." And that's exactly what happened to them. They saw that awesome miracles happen in their own lives.
Wow.
Amazing, hey?
So miracles still happen today.
Absolutely, 100%, of course they do, yeah.
Wow, that is fantastic, isn't it? Oh, wow. Go on, Beck.
It'd be really good for our children to go and explore this a bit more now and go and speak to people that they hear that have had miracles happen in their lives, or ask parents, people they know that go to church, "Have you ever experienced miracles?" So they can go and explore it a little bit more and understand it a bit more.
That's exactly what I was going to say.
Great minds.
There you go. And you know what, Beck, as well? You know, children, if you haven't already experienced one of the miracles of God, I'm sure as they grow, they'll see it for their own eyes.
Absolutely,
when they
grow up. Definitely. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. So, Dee.
Yeah?
You can go back to your magic tricks, not miracles.
No, babe.
Ooh.
Nowhere near
as good as miracles.
As good as a miracle.
Shall we say bye to the children now?
Yeah, okay.
Okay, see you next time.
See you next time. Bye.